Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Annie Rinchen Khandro, Director of Kagyu Samye Dzong, Edinburgh Meditation Centre, and Honorary Buddhist Chaplain, University of Edinburgh, Chaplaincy Service.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. The very thing we're so short of in these testing times, time poor is a phrase I think we can probably all relate to as we try to keep up with the ever-increasing pace of life. Events and challenges seem to come at us from all directions, constantly demanding our attention. It becomes difficult to know what to do first. We may start by dealing with whatever's uppermost in our in-tray, then on to the next thing and the next and the next, with barely a moment in between, like the sorcerer's apprentice, constantly mopping up one deluge after another. Hardly a healthy lifestyle. Indeed, we can become so exhausted and stressed out and anxious that some people even turn to drink or drugs to self-medicate in an effort to blot out the noise. It is understandable. But it hardly the good decisions for ourselves and others. Whether our responsibilities are familial or national or even international, if we wish to do the best by others, we need to be at our best, calm, clear, and compassionate. So it really isn't selfish to take time out to rest and be in nature, reflect, meditate, call it what you will. We wouldn't expect our body to be active 24/7 without respite, yet we seem to ask this of our minds. Isn't it time we gave our minds time and to come home, let go of all the busyness, put down the mental baggage of the day, and rest unencumbered, light, peaceful, but aware? By getting to know our mind in its natural state, we are nourished. Connection to all life forms and indeed to the planet. Then, when it comes time to act, we can do so with renewed energy, wisdom, and compassion for ourselves and others. I'd like to end with a prayer, a Buddhist prayer of aspiration, which I think, I hope, will resonate with you all. May all beings be happy and create the causes of happiness. May we be free from suffering and from creating the causes of suffering. May we find that noble happiness that cannot be tainted by suffering. May we attain universal, impartial compassion, beyond bias to friends or others. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed.